All right, I'm ready.
Good evening. I'm Dr. Emmett Brown. I'm standing on the parking lot at Twin Pines Mall. It's Saturday morning, October 26th, 1985, 1:18 a.m. And this is temporal experiment number one. Come on, Einy. Hey, boy, get in there. That a boy. In you go. Get down. Get your seatbelt on. That's it.
Whoa. Okay.
Please note that Einstein's clock is in precise synchronization with my control watch. Got it?
Right. Check, Doc.
Good. Have a good trip, Einstein. Watch your head.
You got that thing hooked up to the car?
Watch this.
Yeah, okay. Got it.
Not me. The car. The car. If my calculations are correct, when this baby hits 88 miles per hour, you're gonna see some serious shit. Watch this. Displacement occurred at exactly 1:20 a.m. and 0 seconds!
Hot Jesus Christ! Jesus Christ, Doc! You disintegrated Einstein!
Calm down, Marty! I didn't disintegrate anything! The molecular structure of both Einstein and the car are completely intact!
Where the hell are they?
The appropriate question is, when the hell are they? You see, Einstein has just become the world's first time traveler! I sent him into the future! 1 minute into the future, to be exact. And at precisely 1:21 a.m. and 0 seconds, we shall catch up with him and the time machine.
Wait a minute, Doc. Are you telling me that you built a time machine out of a DeLorean?
The way I see it, if you're gonna build a time machine into a car, why not do it with some style? Besides, the stainless steel construction made the flux dispersal. Look out!
Doc?
That's peculiar.
Where's the car, Doc?
It should have caught up with us 27 seconds ago.
Doc, what happened to Einstein?
No need for concern. It's probably just a minor miscalibration of the time circuits. Marty, could you get my notebook? It should be in the toolbox.
Notebook. Got it. Flux capacitor?
That's it!
What the heck's a flux capacitor?
My latest invention. The thing that makes time travel possible. In this notebook, I've detailed the nearly 3 decades of scientific breakthroughs necessary to build a working time machine. If it ever fell into the wrong hands, the consequences could be catastrophic. Let's see. Is mass equals I times Z, and E equals the square root of Z times C squared, and the flux dispersal rate is inversely proportional to the fourth root of N, carry the 9, then.
Doc, shouldn't we get out of here before the Libyans show up? Doc?
Great Scott!
Doc, what is it?
I've made a horrible mistake!
Doc! No!
I'm sorry, Marty.
Doc! Come back! Doc! Doc!
Marty, is everything okay?
Yeah, Mom, it was just a nightmare. I was in the past, and Doc was there.
Well, you're safe and sound now, back in good old 1986. But you'd better get up. Your father's waiting for you.
Huh?
Weren't you going to meet him over at Doc's?
Holy crap, I'm late!
Are we too late to stop the
sale?
Better late than never.
You wouldn't believe how much rare stuff there is back here.
That's Doc stuff. The city has no right
to. Now, son, I know you're upset, but your friend's been gone for months, and the city really seems hell-bent on using his land for that new parking garage. And hey, is that a first edition Jules Verne?
It's just not fair. But at least things can't get any worse.
Hey, Marty!
Hi, Biff.
Come to see if the old crackpot had any buried treasure?
Nah, I guess I'm just remembering.
Hey, let me—
Now, Biff, leave Marty alone. This is a very emotional time for him.
Oh, sure. Sorry, Marty.
Doc didn't take any of these with him. Hey, Dad. Who's running this sale anyway?
Oh, that'd be me, son.
You? Why?
Well, once it became apparent that the bank was going through with the sale, I volunteered to oversee it in order to make sure that Doc's stuff would be treated with a modicum of respect. Isn't that right, Biff?
You got it, Mr. McFly!
I'm telling you, this sale is a joke. Doc's only been gone for a few months, and I happen to know—
Yes, you've told us he's not dead. He's on a trip. Let's say you're right. Have you considered that this trip may not have been entirely voluntary? I hate to say it, but Doc's run up some pretty sizable debts around town. Maybe he's just hiding from his creditors.
You got Doc wrong. Sure, maybe he's not so good with money. That's just because his mind's always on bigger things. But he's still a straight-up guy. He'd never run away from his problems.
Well, you know him better than I do, son. But the bank is within its rights to sell off his stuff. Maybe you should try to find some things to remember him by before Biff grabs them all.
What's Biff doing here? He wasn't a friend of Doc's.
It's a public sale, Marty. Everyone's allowed. Even Biff.
About Biff, Dad, I know you're trying to help.
He talks a big game, son, but he's not so tough. I've been dealing with him a long time. Believe me, I can handle him.
So can I.
I guess you can. Okay, son, I'll stay out of your way. But you know where to find me.
Do you think dreams can predict the future?
Well, you know I don't go in for that mystical stuff. But I do think they can reflect how you're feeling about the future. What did you dream?
Oh, just weird stuff about Doc.
Well, that's understandable, don't you think?
I guess, but I feel like it was telling me something. I'll keep looking around. Thanks, Dad. A fish tank? I never knew Doc raised fish. Doc's fish had weird taste in decor. I kinda like Doc.
Does nature contrive it so that even with a time machine, you can't intervene to prevent your own conception, for example?
Doc built this model of downtown Hill Valley way back in 1955. The clock tower in the courthouse even works. What the? Is that Doc's notebook in there?
Hey, that looks just like the courthouse. You gotta hand it to the old coot. He was good with his hands.
Biff, can I see that a minute?
This would look great in my fish tank. Give the old carp something new to nibble on.
Can I see that model courthouse for just a second? I need to get something out of it.
Like what? A not guilty verdict? That was a joke.
Oh, but really, can I?
Nah, I think I'll hold on to it.
Give it here, Biff.
Well, well, look at what we have here. Looks like plans for something. What's a flux catheter?
It's none of your business. Doc asked me to...
Brown's worm food, kid. But this looks like it might be worth something. Ha!
Seems kind of empty without the courthouse. Feels like that was a lifetime ago. Actually, I guess it was. Hope that wasn't poison gas or anything. Seems kind of empty without the courthouse.
Wait, I got one! Hey, don't cut off my music!
Hey, Biff. I only want that notebook because, well, I'm sentimental. It's like a piece of Doc.
Doc's dead! Time to get over it and move on.
It's just a notebook with Doc's scribblings. What did Doc ever accomplish?
Nothing!
Then it's worthless, right?
If it was really worthless, you wouldn't want it so bad.
That notebook wouldn't mean anything to you. You wouldn't even understand what's in it.
You calling me ignorant?
I just can't let you keep that notebook. It's dangerous.
What, is it set to explode or something?
Well, in a way.
I'll take my chances.
I'll pay you for it.
How much? Not enough.
Never mind. Looks like a hand crank lightning rod, or maybe a lightning powered pencil sharpener. It took me forever to repair this thing after I blew it out last time, and now some jerk's gonna pick it up for pennies. Let's make some noise. Hey, Dad, why's my guitar got a price tag on it?
Sorry, son. Must have been an overzealous clerk. Just pick it up. I'll iron things out with the bank.
Here's an oldie, but a goodie. One, two, three.
Hey, look, it's Chuck Butthead. Let me show you how it's done. Now watch me blow the lid off this joint.
Whatever you say. Rock on, Biff.
Oh, shit.
Doc, where are you? Doc? Einstein! Where do you come from, boy? Didn't you bring Doc with you? Okay, Doc, I know I haven't seen you in a few months, but I'm pretty sure this isn't your shoe.
Marty? Marty, if you're hearing this recording, then the DeLorean's automatic retrieval feature is a resounding success.
Automatic retrieval?
In case of my failure to return to the DeLorean within an allotted time, I programmed the time machine to jump to these four-dimensional coordinates without me. As you are well aware, time travel is an inherently risky activity, and despite my elaborate precautions, there's always the possibility that I could land in trouble sometime. And that sometime is now, or then, or maybe later.
He's in trouble.
Marty, you've come to my rescue in the past, or was it the future? Anyway, I'm relying on you to do it again. Please, take the DeLorean back, or forward, to whatever it is. I'm stuck in time. When you get there, I'm sure you'll figure out what to do.
That's it? Aren't you gonna tell me when that is?
Just go to the date specified on the time circuit readout under the heading marked Last Time Departed. Good luck.
Right. Last time departed. Oh, jeez. Come on. Crap! Oh, great. How am I supposed to find him now? kind of trouble is Doc in, Einie? What do you know about this shoe, Einie? Great Scott! I think he's onto something! Okay, now we're getting somewhere. How's this supposed to lead me to Doc, Einie? It's locked.
Step away from the door! Now, let me get a look at you.
Einstein, come on!
Just as I suspected. Hooligans! Get along now! Scat! State your business, child! You're making me miss Merv!
Well, see, that's the thing. I'm not sure why I'm here. Einstein here brought me, and...
Well?
Can you let me in? I've got something to show you.
What is it? Let me see. A shoe? Wow, now what would I want with a... Huh? Stay there!
Sorry, Einstein.
Well, took you long enough.
There's a lot of stairs.
To return the shoe, I mean. I lost it ages ago. You can put it down next to the other one. Much better. So neat and orderly. I suppose you'll be wanting some sort of reward now.
No, I...
All I've got is tea and candy.
But...
I'm sorry I called you a hooligan. I try not to jump to conclusions, but after all, 9 out of 10 people in this city are hooligans. It's a fact. Look it up. Have a seat, Sonny.
Hey! You kids! Put out those cigarettes!
Don't touch those! My newspapers are in pristine condition and meticulously organized. Not about to let some street punk get jam all over them.
Oh, the candy looks older than I am.
I wouldn't do that if I were you. Ms. Pretty Whiskers is very particular about who handles her food.
Ms. Strickland?
Jack! Diane! I know what you're doing behind that tree!
Yes?
Do you remember when you lost your shoe?
Shoe?
That shoe over there.
Oh, that shoe! Hi, what a nosy Nelly! No one likes a busybody, you know.
But...
Oh, fine, let me think about it. Yes, I remember. I lost it in a scuffle with a dog. Oh, when was it? Oh, yes. The day that speakeasy burned down.
A speakeasy? In Hill Valley?
Don't act so surprised, young man. Your generation doesn't hold a copyright on moral depravity, you know. Sin has been on the prowl in Hill Valley since the day it was founded.
Wow, a speakeasy. That must have been wild. Is it true they used to drink gin out of slippers like my grandma said?
Don't romanticize the past, young man. Prohibition was a time when gangsters ruled the town while honest citizens quaked in their beds.
So where was it? That speakeasy that burned down, I mean.
That was ages ago. If you're looking for bootleg hooch.
No, I'm just curious, that's all. I'm a student of history.
Student of history, my Aunt Fanny. Yeah, your generation of hooligans and slackers could give two ripe figs about history.
Miss Strickland?
Oh, video store!
Huh?
The speakeasy used to be hidden in plain sight down there in the town square. Right where that disgusting videotape rental store squats today.
So the video store building must have gone up after the speakeasy burned down.
Following year, as I recall.
What's with all these newspapers?
This is my personal archive. I've got every issue of the Hill Valley Telegraph ever published.
Get out. Every single issue?
From 1871 to the present. If it happened in Hill Valley, you'll find it in my stacks.
I guess somewhere in these stacks there must be an article about the speakeasy burning down.
Naturally. I probably wrote it myself. I was quite a reporter back in the day.
Any idea what date that article came out?
Well, obviously the day after the speakeasy burned down.
Doing some stargazing?
No, I set my sights on it. Lower things. Is that?
Jim!